Hi guys, I'm Jerusha and you're watching Jerusha Couture TV. New hair in the building. When I get new color, I'm not gonna lie, yeah, it's so like quite dark when it, cause I usually do quite dark color. It feels like I'm wearing a wig. It feels like I've got a unit on, girl. And yes, I have my drag lashes on today. I got a comment once when I wore these. These are my KoKo lashes in the Soho. They're absolutely huge. And I got a comment once like, you look like you're wearing drag queen lashes. And I was like, girl, get your life, respect to the pride. I wanna be a drag queen. I asked you guys on Instagram, video requests, what do you guys wanna see? I love just sort of, you know, putting that out there and then everyone just sort of can say what they're thinking at the time. Maybe they want to see something in particular from me, which there was. So thank you so much for your comments. The most sort of response at the time was on the image, which is this guy. This is the bag I'm currently carrying, which is my Louis Vuitton Noe BB. I did get a question as to what size it was in the post of the picture. It is the BB size, so it comes with the longer strap as the setting. Other Noes are all, they have the shorter straps for the shoulders, but this can be crossbody, so it's the longer strap. All right, I'm just gonna quickly show you what's inside of it, even though I pretty much showed you on the vlog as well, but that's okay, then you'll see what it holds. So this is my pochette, never full pochette, MM size in Damier bin. I hold my receipts in here, or like receipts from doctor's appointments, from Mussy and things like that. And then I just have, you saw this in the vlog, then I just have everything lined up. And this is what I do inside my Speedy 25 as well. But I will say in this bag, it's much easier to sort of keep everything in a line. It doesn't sort of float around like it does in a Speedy. There's a lot more sort of, it's a better weighted bag. I'm gonna say that, because a Speedy is like that black hole and everything just floats around. So it keeps everything contained and really neat and tidy. Here is my iPhone 7 Plus, that sits in the front. The Sunnies, which you may have seen in that vlog, are my Key Australia Desi Perkin Fades in the high key. I have my car key. I have my Louis Vuitton cosmetic case in the toiletry. I have my Louis Vuitton toiletry case in the 15 size. And I have my Agenda PM in the Damier Azur. I have my clay in the Damier Azur. I have some hand wipes. Really, really great. I have random change on the bottom of the bag. That's not really good because it's a light colored interior. Let's just pop that in my wallet, shall we? This is my wallet. I still have my Gucci fully packed to the brim and am really loving it. Just loving this wallet, which I reviewed a couple of videos ago. Then I have a random $100 bill just sitting in the bottom of my bag, and that is all that I have in it. I have said before that I would compare the size to a Speedy 25. It's a little narrower, obviously, so you have to go up, meaning you could stack your bag this way if you want to put more items in it, because it's more narrow than a Speedy 25, but I compare it to that kind of size and the handiness of that bag. This is obviously kind of similar to a Neverfull in the sense that your only sort of security of closure is the drawstring. A Neverfull doesn't really have any complete closure like that. Like if you pull this really tight, there you go, you have complete closure. Whereas the Neverfull doesn't, it just has the clasp, but it has the side drawstrings. But you can't, I mean, obviously, that's what the drawstring is there for, to have complete closure. Do I close it up? No, I actually never close it up. I keep it completely open, just close to my body like so. If I did, I have my drawstring knot here that I learned from Tiff. Hi, babe. She has a fantastic video on how to do this drawstring knot. I've done it with three ties, so it's just a little bit, so it looks a little bit more sort of fancy, I suppose. I did three ties around, but this knot helps you get in and out of the bag if you're continuously pulling it as a drawstring and opening it up to get items out. To do that, obviously, it's just a slip knot. That's exactly what it is. That's all it is. So you grab it by the end that is got slipping through and you pull it like so. And that longer end gets longer and the drawstring pulls close. And to pull it out, you just pull each side. Sorry, this is really hard to do without the bag down. You pull, obviously pull that back out and it opens the drawstring back out. You guys know what a slip knot is. But anyway, so that was from Tiff and I did the same thing. Now that everything's out, to come up nice and close to show you the features. Okay, so this is the Noe BB. As I said, it is the smallest in the line except for the Nano, which is more of a novelty size, which is literally like this big. So you have the Nano, the BB, the Petite Noe, and then the full Noe size, which is the large, like almost GM size, I'd say. All Noes are constructed of one piece of canvas. So this is constructed of one piece of Damier Azur canvas. So it literally wraps around like so. So on the insides, you will see there is no cut seam. On the sides, it is just stitching down the sides for where the vachette side straps are. And then again here, you can see the stitching there. But it is one continuous piece of canvas. This bag was originally designed in the large Noe size. So the, as I said, the GM size, which is a lot larger than this, to hold 5 champagne bottles, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the middle one upside down. With the spout going downwards, and then to be traveling, you know, on a boat in the French Riviera, the south of France, you know, put this on your gorgeous yacht and carry your champagne that way. It was that kind of bag. That is what it was designed for originally, as a champagne transport bag in the way of like luggage. Obviously the Noe is known for its drawstring feature, therefore it has these round circular grommets with Louis Vuitton engraved around them. Mine are tarnished. This is pre-loved, but just like a Speedy, the golden hardware is back when it was the brass, which completely oxidizes, and it's that kind of dull brassware. Again, a lot of us in the luxe community don't really have an answer as to why Vuitton use their kind of dull hardware on Speedies, but they do on the Noe as well, which I guess is a bummer if it concerns you. Tarnishing doesn't concern me. Plus, if you just Brasso this using Brasso, I will link below what Brasso is, and rub it clean with Brasso very neatly. Don't get it on the canvas. It'll just come back up really, really shiny. Like this hardware here on this luggage tag. Shout out to Kevin. Beautiful Kevin gifted me this large luggage tag with the Hawaii hibiscus flower and butterfly a hot stamping on it as a gift. And then it has the Chinese characters on the back hot stamped as well. He got that for me and it was just such a gorgeous gift. I keep it on this bag and I keep it on my Neverfull GM as well. And you can just see it here. It's attached with a Motul hook. I'll also leave them linked below. They're so handy to put on your luggage tags and you can interchange them for your bags. Again, because this is pre-loved, it has beautiful pre-patina on it. So I didn't really have to go through that process. Even though I don't mind going through the process of patina, I think it is so beautiful. I love it and enjoy it. It's so lovely that you can see the beautiful yellow stitching just popping out there, the beautiful contrast of it, and the gorgeous contrast of the red glazing is still there. You can see it around the straps. All the rivets on the bags have Louis Vuitton embossed in them on the outside of the bag. And on the rivet on the inside of the bag is embossed with Louis Vuitton. A really big key feature to a Noe in any size is the base of it. It is going to be made out of full vachette leather, full untreated cowhide leather that is going to be bright white when you buy it, and you have to just literally go through the patina of it. So because it is the base of the bag, you're going to have banging on the corners, and most Noes, especially pre-loved, can have quite severe staining because the bag has been placed down, it gets water transfer, it gets marks and dirtying like so. And so that is just what it is known for. Mine from Fashion File is quite mild in its wear on the base, which is really something when I'm looking, obviously when I was looking for an OA, that's the first thing I looked for is the base and what condition it was in. But a lot of wear on the sides is quite normal for this bag as well, because it bangs around. Again, this one isn't too bad at all. But knowing that it's pre-loved, I knew that, I keep that in mind, and that doesn't really bother me. Like a keep all and like a speedy bandolier style, you will find your made in stamp on a Noe stamped down here on the strapping of the vachette that is sewn down, and mine says made in France. I just love these straps on Noe, whether it is just the shoulder strap or on the BB, which this is a shoulder and crossbody length, so it can be made to be crossbody. You have your adjustments, which there is 5. You have your buckles, and then you have your keepers. These keepers don't move, they're both permanent. And I love this strap. It's really sturdy, it's really lovely. And I think it just, it's very iconic to a Noe that the strap, and even the shoulder strap on the petite Noe and the regular size Noe, is just a really, really nice sturdy strap. So coming down onto the other side of the strap, again, still 5 adjustment holes, your buckles, your D-rings, your rivet, and then on this side, there is the Louis Vuitton Paris stamped there, and then you saw the made in France on the other side. The date code is found underneath the strap where the attachment attaches to the bag there with the vachette, and you have the date code stamped down inside that leather. Moving on to the interior, it is Azur, so you get this lovely cream interior, and again it is that grosgrain canvas interior. So it's really quite tough and sturdy. I will say for cream, it's really great for finding your items because it's light. They don't sort of get lost in a dark, interior that you can't find your items, but it will be more prone to staining, similar to a Neverfull, than versus a darker lining. Inside the interior, there is no covering lining, like an interfacing, so you will see those reverse grommets from the inside, and then the leather drawstring coming through, which I think is kind of a nice feature. So you will see it there as well. Some people remove the drawstring and put a Twilly from Hermes in there, or they get the bandeau from Louis Vuitton and thread a bandeau just to give it a pop of color and a bit of fun for your bag. Down on this side of the bag, we have a little leather tab with a rivet saying Louis Vuitton, and then you have your iconic D-ring. I love that there's a D-ring in the Noe. I think it's really nice. It's a nice feature because obviously it is one big compartment. You don't have any zipper pockets in this bag whatsoever. This bag still has that kind of original Louis Vuitton scent to it that I used to just love. I can't say where it went. I'm gonna say probably maybe the use of the glue or something like that, but I just love that smell. Hey, I am going to stand up and throw in some mod shots here as well on my frame, so that you can sort of see it on the body, cross body, and on the shoulder, being the BB size. Obviously, you have that option, as I said. Pros and cons of this bag while I'm doing that. I will tell you, most to all of my points are pros. I think that this is just a phenomenal bag. I have enjoyed it. If you have noticed, it has stayed in my collection. I have not sold it. I know a lot of people see me unbox bags and be like, oh, that's gonna leave her collection really soon, girl. Well, this one has stayed in. It has worked for me. I love it. And it is along the lines of a Speedy 25. So a lot of questions I get is, would I, if I had the choice again, purchase this over the Speedy 25? The answer to that would be no. If you have followed me, I am a diehard Speedy 25 bandolier, preferably 25 lover of Louis Vuitton. I'm just a diehard fan of that bag. I wouldn't purchase this over that bag, but I definitely would save to have both. I have both in my collection now. I see a place and a need for both. You have a zipper closure on one and, you know, a drawstring closure on another. That would definitely be the only con I can think of. Maybe for you, it is, again, not a con for me, but the closure system is a drawstring bag. It's much more of kind of a design feature and a novelty rather than, oh, you know, I'm going to buy this bag for uni or for work or to take, you know, travels, things like that. That's where a Speedy with the zipper closure is going to work so much better for you over something like this. Do you kind of understand what I'm saying? You wouldn't necessarily reach straight for this bag. That is the only con I can think of. Damier Azur, is it a con now for me? I'm going to say no. Because I've learned how it works for me, and pre-loved is that way. Yes, of course, on a hot summer's day wearing all black, you know, there's still chance of color transfer, but knowing that it's not a, you know, brand new raw canvas, raw vachette that's just really gonna soak up anything, and someone who wears black around the clock, girl, that's not going to work for my lifestyle. So pre-loved is definitely the way to go for me on the Damier Azur front. I know a lot of you get scared of Damier Azur 2 out there. That's my answer for that. And there is nothing wrong with it. There is absolutely nothing wrong with pre-loved. You guys know that I'm a huge advocate for it now. Well, that is my answer for Damier Azur. Final thoughts on this bag and this canvas is it's just fun. When I see it, and I always sort of have it behind me, it's so fresh, it's so fun. A lot of people say that Damier Azur is a summer canvas. I totally agree with that. If you want to be an all-round year girl, then you do it. You rock it every season, that's no worries. It is winter right now in Australia. I'm bundled up and I'm still carrying this bag currently. It doesn't matter for us, because if you came here to Australia, you'd be like, it is not a four-season country, girl. It is summer all year round, which is kind of true. So it doesn't really matter for me. But if you only pull out your Azur in summer, well, good for you. I don't mind that at all. That's completely fine. But I think it's just a fun, fresh, happy canvas, and this is a happy little bag. Do I believe it holds enough? Absolutely. Because I'm such an advocate for a Speedy 25 bandolier, I feel the same way about this. And right now, as you just saw with a what's in my bag with this, it has a ton in it. And if I wanted to and I was doing more things, I have my fashion file bottle, a water bottle right here. Obviously, it's going to stick up a little bit, but that can go in there as well. You know, it's one of those bags that can just maneuver in and out of things that you're doing and what you need it for. Okay, so that brings me to the end of my review on this bag. Thank you so much for requesting it, guys, on my Instagram on a video request. I love doing that. I'm actually going to do that so much more because it's so instant, you know. I just see what you guys want to see, and it's just better that way rather than sort of scheduling videos and just, you know, churning them out. It's really what content you guys want to see. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up. If you like the Noe BB or any of the Noes, give this video a thumbs up. I think it is a classic Louis Vuitton bag. I think it is so beautiful in the, you know, construction and just the that original kind of feeling of Vuitton. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already and you wish to do so, guys, that'd be really cool. I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Peace.